In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, everybody in the conference knows that the Blue Hose are getting better and better and better, and we have highlights to prove it. We'll talk with the coach about the outstanding win against UNC Asheville and that great, great effort at home against the Highlanders of Radford. All that and more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball. We welcome you to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, along with the coach, Gregg Nibert. I'm your host, Eric Thacker. Coach, congratulations. And I mean, not only on the win against UNC Asheville, but where this team has come from the beginning of the season. I think you and your players need to be congratulated.
Well, thank you, Eric. And it really, it starts with the players and especially our staff. And we really talked about all this, leading up to even the Liberty win and us not having everybody really at full strength.
That's right.
Until this past, maybe 10 days. And we're really 2-1, considering the Liberty win, even though we didn't have Jordan Downing.
Right.
But we've got everybody at full strength and everybody back in playing the right positions with Janiel and Devon at the point guard position. And then, at the two, we've got obviously Marcus Terry and Jaron and Will Adams, and then obviously Jordan at the three. And then right on down the line with a healthy Deshaun and Will Truss and Ruben and everybody and Ed Drew coming off that bench is really 2-1 in this league and so close to being almost 3-0. If we'd have taken better care of the ball and played a little bit better defense against Radford, we're really 3-0 and playing our best basketball of the season.
Before I talk to you, Coach, about breaking down the Asheville Bulldog game, I want to share this with our viewers. Folks, in our stat sheet, in the early part of the year, what we call the hustle stats, points of off of turnovers, points after rebounds, points in the paint, points off the bench. We were on the lower end of that. Mm-hmm. Now all of a sudden Presbyterian College is leading in most of those categories against some of the best teams in the conference. Coach, congratulations on that as well, because there is the proof in the pudding, the improvement. Now if you would break down this UNC Asheville game, the Bulldogs, very, very solid team. And, boy, your Blue Hose played lights out.
Well, we did, and we really talked about we've not won two games in a row and mm-hmm. coming off a very good win against Liberty and going on the road and playing a great defensive game and getting some consistency with our effort and really came out. And probably the first 20 minutes really won the game for us. In the last 5 minutes of the half, we took a 35-22 lead, and our defense was tremendous in terms of holding them to 22 points, and what a great win it was. The way the second half rolled around is they fought back and took a 5-point lead, and for us to go a little man-to-man and make some stops, and then just had some great guys, Will Truss make a three, Jordan Downing make a great drive, and obviously Deshaun Murray, making four free throws in a row of a hard-nosed, tough, very young basketball team,
right,
knowing what it takes to win on the road in a very tough place to play, who they don't lose much at home in Asheville.
Oh, and their numbers prove it. One of the best home records in the Big South Conference. You mentioned switching from the zone to man-to-man. I think that caught the Bulldogs off guard, and then they couldn't battle as well as they were battling on that comeback.
Well, it was, and obviously Rousey was hitting some threes. We weren't getting to him in the
deep
zone.
Deep threes,
and we need to do a much better job of that. But our guys did go man-to-man and make some big-time stops, and obviously some great offensive plays by our two seniors and Deshaun Murray.
All righty, Coach, let's go ahead and dive into the highlights, please. That is the Blue Hose and the Bulldogs of Asheville.
Game Highlights is brought to you by Cooper Motor Company. If you can't trade with Cooper, you just can't trade.
Well, it was a great win, and again on the road, and playing with our poise and toughness. You can see we're down six in the first half, but they're playing a little zone there. And what a great, you know, Marcus has really improved his shooting.
Sure has.
Again, we're in the zone, doing a good job. We get him going baseline. Devon pitches the ball ahead, and Marcus is probably one of the best guys in the league at finishing on the break. You can see Devon there giving the fist. We get a big steal, another lay-in, again, picking up full floor. Again, we got every loose ball in this game, which was unbelievable. Great drive there and great finish by Deshaun. And you can see now it's 20-all with 5 minutes to go, and we just go on a 15-2 run. Great pass there by Deshaun. Look at him, Devon picking up, running a set play. Good pull up by Jordan Downing. You can see now it's 31-22. Again, another great defense. Great job of pitching the ball ahead. And Marcus, again, our hustle plays.
Absolutely.
You know, we're absolutely tremendous. Another loose ball rebound, another pitch ahead. Again, 35-22, and Deshaun Murray getting Freshman of the Week for the fifth time all season. I think the sixth is a record. Again, they started pressing us. Now, what we did is we had some bad turnovers. Good hustle there. Again, Ed Drew was absolutely tremendous. I think he might have been 5 for 6 in finishing down there on the block.
Mm-hmm.
Great step through the trap. Good patience there by Jordan. Great pass, hitting the ball. How awesome was that of Deshaun hitting it right there and flushing that thing. And Ed might be probably one of the most improved players on the team. And a great finish there by Jordan. Not just throwing the ball up there, but finishing. You can't just throw it up there. Great pass out there. Great pull up by Marcus. Great offensive rebound there, keeping it alive. Again, jump hook there by Deshaun. Again, offensive rebounding. You can see they made that run. Again, that's over 7 foot. Another sure. Dunk where Ed's gotten really, really good at finishing plays. Devon had his best game probably his career. He had 8 assists and 2 turnovers coming off the bench. You can see we're very unselfish. We had 20 assists and 9 turnovers. Again, now they've got a 5-point lead with 4:27 to go. A nice pass. That right there probably, you know, we'll trust to have the confidence in making that 3 down 5. They're still down 4 with 3:50 to go. Great pull-up jump shot there by Deshaun. I think he made 6 straight points, or maybe even 8 straight points. Here's a great set play the guys ran, and great screen by Jordan. Well, that answers the question. I think he had 8 straight points because he had 2 buckets and he had 4 free throws. And this is a guy that's a winner. That he might shoot 59% overall from the free throw line, but in the last 5 minutes, the guy's about 100%. That shows his toughness. Big drive right here, our seniors. Again, Jordan driving baseline, giving us a 2-point lead. We're in man-to-man. Marcus is on Rousey. We need a big-time stop. He takes a 3 out there. Great block out there by Will Truss. We should have stayed with our checkout, though, better. Devon should have stayed with his checkout. But Marcus Terry dives on the floor. We did a dive-on-the-floor drill the day before practice with Marcus diving on the floor. And what a great play that was. Again, Jordan making both free throws to steal the victory and give you a 4-point lead. Again, free throws are big, and the toughness that he showed and Will shown was absolutely tremendous for 2 seniors. Again, you don't want to foul. That was close. You definitely don't want him to get close there, you know. And again, time runs out. Blue Hose win, and what a great win it was on the road. And probably like a signature win in the last 2.5 to 3 years to win on the road, especially against a team that's in first place.
Well, Coach, outstanding highlights on both ends of the floor. We saw it. The team plays a little bit mm-hmm. more aggressive. I don't want to say a little bit. They're much improved. They are a complete team, and everybody steps in and helps.
Well, they are, and that's what we have to do. You know, our mm-hmm. our MO that has to be our defense, and we played great defense the other night against, obviously, Asheville, and we got guys stepping up and coming off that bench, and it's a total team effort. Even the guys cheering over there that aren't getting in the games, You know, Stephen Osu, Charlie, you know, Reggie Dillard coming over there, Jake Campbell. I mean, it is a total team effort by everybody over there pulling for this team on the bench, in the huddles, coming off the bench, accepting their role. And as I told the guys, you know, the teams this time of year, they're either getting, you know, tighter and tougher, or they're getting away from each other and they're thinking about themselves. And this team is definitely, you know, getting tighter and tougher, and couldn't be more proud of them.
I want to expand on the word tough. Folks, remember that PC had a 15-point lead, then 13-point lead at the half. Asheville, very good at home, was really good defensively, picked up us in the backcourt, and ended up getting a 5-point lead late in the ball game. When a team has a double-digit lead, then all of a sudden is down by five, a lot of teams sometimes just pack it in and get out of there. Not the Blue Hose. They fought through that, were able to obtain the lead, and then hold on to it. You want to talk about toughness? I think that's it there.
Well, you're right. And like you said, it starts with your character and your toughness of your team. And you know, one guy that's really, you know, brings that, and we've really missed, you know, for 12 games, was Sean Murray. He's one of the most incredible freshmen that I've ever coached. Not only his athleticism, but you know, he's over there talking, and his energy and effort is absolutely tremendous. And he's over there saying things that a leader and a great player says, we're not going to lose this game. And he backs it up with his effort. And guys follow at that. And he's even helping some of the seniors sometimes because they're kind of quiet. But his leadership and his toughness have been tremendous.
All righty. You end with UNC Asheville. Now, your congratulations is taking on one of the most talented and athletic teams in the conference. And oh, by the way, Radford at that time was the top of the conference. We'll take a look at those highlights and again have our visit with Coach when we return right here on Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And Fats Cafe of Clinton.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
You're watching Inside Blue Hose Basketball on the CW.
That's a wrap, Scotty. Let's break for lunch, guys.
All right, it's boat time.
Two-piece dinner.
Right here.
Hey, I had a two-piece dinner.
Relax, man. We got more. Cajun filet biscuit.
That's me.
You got a Cajun filet biscuit and a two-piece dinner?
So what's your point?
Man, you can't have breakfast and lunch together. That doesn't work.
Works for me. I call it brunch.
Get our famous chicken, made from scratch buttermilk biscuits, and legendary iced tea anytime you crave it. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know.
It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run! Oh, hey.
How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late night favorites.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith.
We'll be right back.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by McDonald's of Lawrence and Clinton. I'm loving it. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. When the Blue Hose faced the Highlanders in Radford, Virginia, they had 90-some points. PC had 80-some points. Gregg Nibert said, this game's got to be different. Defense has got to be the story, and boy, was it.
Well, it was, Eric. Unfortunately, though, our defense could have been a little bit better. We did hold them to 62 points, which was great, from 95 to 62. Had some really tough turnovers. You can't turn the ball over 20 times, and they got some easy baskets off our turnovers. And then we didn't do a good enough job of blocking them out. But we had them right down there. Had a chance to win the game against the first-place team, and what a difference the game was from up there.
Let's go ahead and dive in. The Blue Hose and the Highlanders of Radford.
Well, it was a great atmosphere, and we talked about we're trying to win three games in a row, which was really neat, and we got to stop there. We really want to push the ball. We're not quite pushing that basketball as hard and as fast as we want to do and getting the ball down inside on a make. We did a little on-ball screen right there and throwing it back there to Deshaun. Again, great shot fake. He's got a great, really nice shot fake and drives it in there. Again, you see they got 7 points, you know, only in 7 minutes, so we're being patient on offense. We were really patient in the first half. Weren't quite as patient in the second half. Again, great jump shot there. Great gap dribble there by Jaron, and great assists right there. Again, right there at the high post, Deshaun Murray hitting that jump shot right there at the high post. You can see 15-9. We're not scoring many points, but the game is still right in there. Again, Janiel getting that steal right there with his athleticism, and great finish there by Marcus. Again, you see the score at 17-15, showing some patience. We didn't really drive that ball off far enough on the on-ball screen. Great cut in there by Janiel, and great finish over 6'9" there by Janiel, and great pass. Nice finish. See it 19-all with 7 minutes to go against the first place team. Great pass in there by Devon, and great screen there. Again, we're right in the game. Good pitch ahead. This is a really nice finish, and Devon wasn't doing that. Sometimes as freshmen, you just be happy with throwing the ball up there. Now he's finishing and getting an and-one, which was a great, great finish there by Devon. 4 minutes to go in the half. Need to set a better screen there by Jordan. Better down screen there. We're not screening like we really should have, and we worked on that. Again, pull-up jump shot there for three, but again, that was mostly done on his ability. We didn't screen really well enough on that possession. Again, right there, we're trying to get Deshaun the ball there on a drive. Come right back to the middle with the right-hand hook. Again, that's a pretty unstoppable play. Again, they pressed us. This is the one time we didn't turn it over, all right? Again, trying to get the ball. Another great move there, getting the ball in the middle and making basically a left-hand layup by taking the ball in the middle. We don't want the guy driving the middle of the zone. What a great, great defensive rebound. Go. Pushing the basketball, great pitch ahead. Unfortunately, that was the only time we got that over the top, and we need to work on that more, but great job of running the floor by Will. Another great outlet here, 2-on-1. We're getting more easy baskets than we've ever, because we've got so much more quickness, you know, out there at the guard position, which is tremendous, and great pass there by Janiel, and great running the floor. They saw something in the zone, Jaron and Janiel, and great pass right there. Again, what we did the second half, though, is we really dribbled too much. We took things off the dribble. Again, great offensive rebound here and great flush. But again, we should have screened more. Again, you can see, though, the game is 53-all with 4 minutes to go. And they go out ahead 7, you know. But the game shouldn't have. We did too much dribbling, too much dribbling. Great pull up there by Marcus. Again, we never quit, lose the game by 6, but we learned a lot in that game, which will help us hopefully in the tournament, and hopefully will help us against Charleston Southern on Tuesday.
A coach always, when he breaks down film, says, oh, we should have done this and we should have done that. But again, folks, that was the most athletic team in the conference right now. PC had a lead, you know, you got to go. And it was back and forth, 1 to 3 points in a lot of that contest. But there again, much improved PC, proving again that they can fight and play anybody in conference as we head toward the beach here in a couple of weeks. Let's go ahead and take our last time out. When we come back, we'll visit with Coach and talk about the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, take a look at the health of the team, and of course, Bear Transport look ahead.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
You're watching Inside Blue Hose Basketball on the CW.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know. It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run!
Oh, hey.
How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late-night favorites.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith. 106 West Main Street, Clinton.
That's a wrap, Scotty. Let's break for lunch, guys.
All right, it's boat time.
Two-piece dinner.
Right here.
Hey, I had a two-piece dinner.
Relax, man. We got more. Cajun filet biscuit.
That's me.
You got a Cajun filet biscuit and a two-piece dinner?
So what's your point?
Man, you can't have breakfast and lunch together. That doesn't work.
Works for me. I call it brunch.
Get our famous chicken, made from scratch buttermilk biscuits and legendary iced tea anytime you crave it. Bojangles, it's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by Bojangles. It's bow time. The city of Clinton, where the tea is sweet and the tea is silent. And by Hickory Hills Barbecue, for all your barbecue catering needs.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Coach, you said it at the beginning of the show that the health of the team is better having everybody back.
Well, it is, and we've been through probably the most adversity and injuries.
With a capital A.
Yeah, and everybody's key, but probably our three top players, and Deshaun being out 12 games, you know, Jordan Downing being out three with the back spasms, and then Will Truss, the second half of High Point when we're right in that game, and then he missed the next three games. So right now, like I said, we've got all the guys back. We're injury-free, and Reggie's doing great, so we're excited, and hopefully, Lord willing, we'll stay healthy.
I tell you what, if ever you get a chance to meet Reggie Dillard, he has the biggest, brightest smile, and even on the bench, cheers on his team as anybody in uniform, and we can't wait to have him back next year. Now time for our Bear Transport look ahead.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Baird Transport for all your logistical and material transport needs.
Okay, Coach, it begins tonight. All these teams are excellent basketball teams. High Point.
Well, it is, and what a great game we had at home, and was right in there. I think it was a three-point game.
That's right.
They hit some big threes, but most importantly, we lost Will Truss in that first half to a concussion, and against John Brown, Ed did a tremendous job coming off the bench, and couldn't have been prouder of Ed, and not only in that game, but what Ed has done when Will has been out, and so proud of our effort, but we're going to have our greatest effort, best defensive effort, taking care of the ball the whole nine yards against everybody.
Coach, break down that game tonight. What do we do? Because you've had success against John Brown.
Well, we got to do a great job of knowing where he is, whether he's in the zone and in the short corner up at the high post or on the block. We've got to do a great job of knowing where he is and really try to keep the ball out of his hands. the only way you're going to stop him is if we don't have a bullet in his gun and try to not to let him catch the ball. And if he does catch it, we got to do a much better job on our traps. And he split a couple traps. And matter of fact, on the game, on the play that Will got his concussion, he split the trap and his shoulder hit Will's chin accidentally, and it was like a prize fighter. But yes, we got to keep him in that trap and not let him get out of that trap.
Coach, as we wind down this regular season, let's look ahead to next week and some special dates on the calendar for PC basketball.
Well, it is, and one of the most the biggest dates, and can't believe this date is coming around, especially for Will Truss and Jordan Downing, their senior night against Coastal Carolina and what they've done. Will's been here for 4 years. Obviously, Jordan's been here for four but only played three, and how far those guys have come. Will Truss, couldn't be prouder. I know when he got in here as a freshman, he ran a mile the first day, and I think he might have been still running. He ran an 8.5-minute mile. He's lost weight. He's chiseled and benches over 300-and-some pounds, can run like a deer, one of the most athletic post players we've ever had. And Jordan Downing came in here just as a shooter, and all the things Jordan Downing has done and meant to this program, leading the team, better passer, better defensive player, and what a great night hopefully it'll be, and want to get everybody out there.
And, Coach, again, that is a Thursday night tip, Coastal senior night. Everybody needs to be at the Templeton Center for this one. Coach, always a pleasure. Mm-hmm. Thank you again for joining us. And, again, congratulations on where this team is now. Okay, the growth has been phenomenal. So, for Coach Gregg Nibert, I'm Eric Thacker. Thank you for joining us once again here on Inside Blue Hose Basketball. And as we wind down the season, get ready. Make that trip to the beach with us, because the Blue Hose have something in store for you.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And Fats Cafe of Clinton. I'd like to thank the following Blue Hose sponsors: Swaim Brown Accounting Services and Wealth Management with David Ramage, Bishop Tire, Pepsi Cola, Number One Sign Designs, Nichols Automotive, Foothills Motorsports, Arthur State Bank, Babcock Sports, Domino's Pizza, Streamers, Pizza Hut, Sodexo Food Services, The Camp Team, Hampton Inn. Thank you again for being Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors.